Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhar, Sri Vasudev Gaur Bhaktavinda, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're reading the Madhya Lila of Chaitanya Charitamrita, and we're on chapter 15.
我们这几天在阅读的是《Chaitanya Charitamrita》中期逍遥的，我们现在读到了第十五章。
Lord Chaitanya had said farewell to all the devotees from Bengal. They'd stayed there in Jagannath Puri for the 4 months of Chaturmasya, and then after the 4 months of Chaturmasya, they went back to Bengal.
参加团扎节之后又待了四个月的孟加拉的奉献者跟他们道别，之后孟加拉奉献者就返回了孟加拉。So
Lord Chaitanya gave each of them instructions and told them what they should be doing and wished them well.
参加团扎就叙述了他们每个人各自的职责和服务，之后对他们进行了祝福。
So then the Bhattacharya, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, wanted to invite Lord Chaitanya to come for lunch at his house.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 希望邀请主Chaitanya到自己的家中来吃午餐。
So the Bhattacharya wanted Lord Chaitanya to come for 30 days. In other words, he wanted him to come every day. But Lord Chaitanya said, no, that's not possible. Sannyasis can't do that. Sannyasis cannot do that. Sannyasis, they can stay in someone's house for 3 days. They shouldn't stay more than 3 days. After 3 days, then it becomes trouble for people.
再过三天呢，对于房子的主人来说，就是有一点麻烦，困难。
When Prabhupada came to Nairobi in Kenya, Africa, Prabhupada was staying in Indian houses. So he would only stay 3 days in each house.
他在每一个就是印度家庭当中呢，只住三天。And
then 3 days he moved to another house.
就过了三天之后呢，他就又到另外一个家庭当中再住三天。This
way you don't get attached to being in a comfortable situation.
这样呢，你就不会依附一个舒适的处境了。
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he wanted Lord Chaitanya to come to his home. But Lord Chaitanya said, well, I'm not going to come all the... Bhattacharya said, well, come for 20 days.
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya Bhattacharya
So then Lord Chaitanya said no. So then he said 15 days. Lord Chaitanya still didn't agree. So the Bhattacharya fell at the feet. He was holding Lord Chaitanya's feet. He was begging him, please, please. And then he said at least 10 days. But Lord Chaitanya said, no, no more than 5 days. I can come for 5 days, no more than 5 days. But Lord Chaitanya has 10 sannyasis staying there in Jagannath Puri, who are all his friends and associates. So he arranged that they would go to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's home, and that they would take prasadam there at his house. And in this way, for 30 days, he had guests coming to his home for lunch. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya had a wife. Her name was Satira Mata. Satira Mata.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya had a 妻子名叫 Satira Mata.
Yeah, Mata means mother, and so it means she was the mother of Sati.
Mata 的意思是母亲, 所以她是Sati的母亲.
So she was a great devotee of Lord Chaitanya, and she was just like a mother to him. So Lord, when the Bhattacharya came home, then he told his wife that Lord Chaitanya is coming for lunch today. So his wife was very happy. And she began to cook a big feast. In Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's home, there was always a full stock of food. And in order to cook for Lord Chaitanya, Bhattacharya, he went to arrange to get all the vegetables and spinach and fruit. So the Bhattacharya went to the market, he collected everything and brought it home. And then Sarvabhauma would go in the kitchen and he would help his wife to cook. Actually, his wife was a very expert cook. She knew how to cook very nicely. So, beside their kitchen, next to the kitchen, there were two rooms, and these two rooms were for offering food. And in one of the rooms, the food was offered to Shaligram, which is a form of Lord Narayan. So because Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya followed the Vedic culture, he was worshipping the Shaligram Shila.
因为 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 遵守伟大文化，所以他崇拜 Shalagram Shila。
And the Shalagram Shila which he worshipped was a form of Lord Narayan.
他所崇拜的 Shalagram Shila 是如 Narayan 的形象。
And Srila Prabhupada says, he said, in India, every Brahmana will worship the Shalagram Shila.
Srila Prabhupada 说，在印度，每一位婆罗门都崇拜 Shalagram Shila.
Usually, they'll do the worship in their home.
他们通常都会在家中崇拜。
Right. These are Grihastha Brahmins. They're Brahmins, but they're Grihasthas. So they would do puja in their home for the Shalagram.
So they are Grihastha Brahmins. They are Grihasthas. They would do puja in their home for the Shalagram.
And they would worship the Shalagram Shila and offer their food, whatever they cooked, they would offer to the Shalagram Shila every day. And they won't eat before first they must do the worship. After they take their bath, then they will worship the Shalagram Shila, and they cannot eat anything until they first worship the Shalagram Shila.
These 婆罗门他们首先沐浴，然后他们崇拜，就是在他们崇拜之前呢，他们是会一直进食。
So the worship of the Shalagram Shila is compulsory in the home of a Brahmana.
崇拜 Shalagram Shila 就是在婆罗门的房子当中，家里头是必须的。
But Kshatriyas and Vaishyas, they also can worship the Shalagram. So you see, the worship of the Shalagram is for people of the higher class, higher caste.
从这一点当中呢，我们可以看出崇拜 Shalagram Shila 是那些高阶层的人士从事的。
They have to be pure and they have to be regulated.
他们必须纯粹有规律。
They have to strictly follow four principles.
他们要严格遵守四项规范原则。
And they have to wake up early in the morning to do this puja. Okay, so there were two rooms beside the kitchen. One room was for making the offering, and the other room was where they were serving lunch to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
So it's in the kitchen, the kitchen next to the kitchen, there are two rooms. One room is used for供奉的。另外一个房间是用作招待住柴丹尼马巴布吃午餐的。
This room where he was to take lunch, this had been just recently built by the Bhattacharya, and it was built specially for the purpose of serving lunch to Lord Chaitanya.
那间专门用来给主柴丹尼马巴布吃午餐的房间，是 Bhattacharya 专门给主柴丹尼盖的，是刚刚盖好的。
It was a very quiet, peaceful room, very suitable for him to take lunch without any disturbance.
这间房间是非常僻静、安静的，很适合主柴丹尼马巴布吃午餐。
And there was only one door. There was only one door opening onto the outside, which people coming, they could enter and they could come through that door to see Lord Chaitanya.
那个房间呢，有一扇门是通往 外界的，外面的人可以从这扇门就进来，可以看住柴太娘。
But there was another door, which was attached to the kitchen, and when they brought the food, they would bring the food from the kitchen through that door.
还有另外一扇门是跟厨房相连的，通过这扇门可以把食物端进这个房间。
So they made a lot of, they cooked a lot of rice. You know, Bengali people like rice, and they cook a lot of rice. They cooked 6 pounds of rice.
他们就烹制了大量的米饭。孟加拉人喜欢吃米饭，他们烹制了6磅的米饭。
So, we're going to hear a description of all the food they cook for Lord Chaitanya.
接下来我们就来听一下，他们是给主柴塔尼亚烹制了什么样的午餐。
This Chaitanya Charitamrita is written by a person called Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, and he not only wrote this book.But he was also an expert cook.
This book, Chaitanya Charitamrita, the author is Krishna Das Kaviraj. He not only is the author of this book, he is also an expert cook.
So he knows exactly how they prepared everything, how they did the cooking.
So he completely understands every detail.
So they had this big pile of rice, 6 pounds of rice on a big banana leaf. And then they added some, they mixed it with butter, yellow and nice fragrant smelling butter.
他们就把6英镑的大米饭就放在一片香蕉叶上。然后倒在上面倒上了金黄色的、冒着香气的纯净的酥油。
Then there were many pots which were all filled with different vegetables, and they were placed at the side of the leaf.
在香蕉叶的四周就放了各种陶罐，里面装满了各式各样的蔬菜。
And there were 10 different kinds of spinach.
有十种、
right? spinach 菠菜。
有十种菠菜 shark。
And then there was a soup which was made with bitter neem leaves。
还有一种是用苦的 neem 叶子做成的汤。
And there was a cake which was made of.Fried cheese.
还有用炸奶酪做成的糕点。
And there were all kinds, different kinds of vegetables which were prepared.
烹制了各式各样的蔬菜。
There were an unlimited quantity of.Different fruits and roots.
有很多种的很多种类很多数量的大量的水果，大量的根茎类的食物。
Lord Chaitanya liked to eat roots and fruits.
主柴丹尼亚他喜欢吃水果和。根茎类的食物。
He liked to eat simply. He didn't eat a lot of opulent food.
他喜欢吃的简单，他不喜欢吃非常奢华食物。
So there was a soup made with urd dal, mung dal, and it was like nectar.
有用 绿豆和或者是乌冬，就这种豆子做成的汤，那个汤品的味道尝起来就像甘露。
And there was about five or six different kinds of sour preparations.
还有五到六种酸的，酸的菜肴。
And there was a sweet chutney.
还有甜的酸辣酱。
And there were sweet bananas and sweet rice and cakes.
有甜香蕉，甜米饭，还有甜的糕点。
And there were cakes made from coconut.
以及用椰子烹制的糕点。
And there were so many different kinds of cakes that we just cannot describe them.
还有各式各样品种类繁多的糕点。无法一一例举。
So some sweet rice was mixed with ghee, and it was poured into the pot.
有一些甜奶饭是和酥油混合在了一起，被倒在了陶罐里。
And then it was mixed with condensed milk and mango.
又混上了浓炼乳以及芒果。
You could imagine it must have been very delicious. Sweet rice with ghee and then mango and condensed milk. Oh my goodness, very delicious.
We can 设想一下，这它的味道一定是非常的美味，有酥油、甜米饭，再加上炼乳还有芒果混合在一起，味道一定非常美。
And then there were different kinds of Bengali sweets, like sandesh, which is made from cheese.
还有各种的孟加拉的甜品 ，sandesh， 用奶酪做的甜品。
All the different sweets of Bengal and Orissa, they were all varieties. They were all prepared.
有各式各样的孟加拉样式的或者是 Orissa 样式的各式各样的甜品准备了。
So the Bhattacharya had a big feast arranged to offer to Lord Chaitanya.
Bhattacharya 就安排了一个大餐给主 Chaitanya.
And on both sides of the food, there were big pot pictures, a pot, you know, carrying...which was full with nice scented cold water.
在这个丰盛的食物两边呢，有陶罐，有那个水罐，水罐里面有芳香的凉水。
And the manjaris from the tulsi tree were placed on the top of the pile of rice.
带着米饭堆成的叫大米饭山。这一堆米饭上面放了库拉西的曼加瑞花。
And then the Bhattacharya had brought a lot of Mahaprasadam from Lord Jagannath's temple.
Sarabhauma 还从 Jagannath 的庙里头带来了许多的 Jagannath 的 Mahaprasadam.
The special sweet balls which are offered to Lord Jagannath and the sweet rice also and cakes.They were all there, and it was all kept for Lord Chaitanya's pleasure.
给主迦格纳的供奉的特殊的甜球、甜米饭、糕点，都他们在那里摆放在那里，都是为了主柴丹尼亚来为了他的高兴来吃放在那里的。
So.That was the prasadam from Lord Jagannath was kept separate so that they could give it to Lord Chaitanya. They knew he would especially enjoy to take remnants from Lord Jagannath.
Jagannath's prasadam was kept 单独的放置。巴达查亚知道主柴丹尼亚会很喜欢品尝这些玛哈普沙。
So Lord Chaitanya finished his midday duties. Every day he has to take bath, he would go to the sea, take his bath and chant Gayatri. And then he came back to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's house.
每天中午，如柴丹尼亚会去沐浴，之后念诵 Gayatri Mantra. 然后今天这一天呢，他就来到了 Bhattacharya 家中，准备吃午餐。
So first of all, the Bhattacharya washed the feet of Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya entered the room to take his lunch.
首先，巴达查亚就给主柴丹尼亚为他洗了莲花足，之后主柴丹尼亚就进入了房间，准备坐下来吃午餐。
And when Lord Chaitanya saw all the food, so much food, he was surprised and he spoke to Bhattacharya.
当主柴丹尼亚看到这么多品种繁多的食物的时候，他有点吃惊，他就如下的对巴达查亚说道。
He said, "You know, you only had about 6 hours to do the cooking. You've cooked so much. I don't know how you could manage to cook so many preparations."
你只有六个小时的时间来准备这些食物。我不知道你是怎么在这么短的时间准备出了这么丰盛的食物。
Lord Chaitanya said, even if 100 men were cooking on 100 stoves, they couldn't finish all these preparations within such a short time.
即便是100个厨师在100个炉子上烹饪，他们也无法在这么短的时间内做这么多的食物。
And Lord Chaitanya said, I see that there are tulsi flowers on it, so I assume you've already offered the food to Krishna.
主柴丹尼亚说，我看见在这个食物上面摆放了布拉西的花蕾，这一定已经供奉过。
So Lord Chaitanya told the Bhattacharya, you're very fortunate. You've done such wonderful offering for Radha and Krishna.
主柴丹尼亚说，你太幸运了，你给 Radha Krishna 供奉了这么美好的食物。
And Lord Chaitanya said that rice, the color of the rice looks so nice, and the smell is so good. I think Radha and Krishna must have already enjoyed it.
主柴丹尼亚说，这个米饭的颜色是这么诱人，它的香味是如此的芬芳。Radha Krishna 一定是直接品尝了。
Lord Chaitanya said, I don't know how I can glorify you enough. I'm so fortunate to be able to take the remnants of the food.
主柴丹尼亚说，我不知道我怎么用充分的语言来赞美你了。我太幸运了，能够吃到这些食物的觊觎。
So Lord Chaitanya said, take away Krishna's sitting place and put it on the side and give me a little prasadam on a different plate.
主柴丹尼亚说，把 Krishna 的座位放在一边，给我一个单独的盘子，放一些 prasadam.
But the Bhattacharya said, oh, this is not so wonderful. Everything was made possible by your mercy.
巴达查尔说，这个就不太好，美妙了。主啊，一切都是由于您的能量才变得可能。
My wife and I, we didn't spend a lot of energy to do all this cooking.
我的妻子和我并没有费很大的力气来烹饪。
The person who gave us the power to prepare this food knows everything.
赋予我们的力量来烹制所有这些食物的人，那个人他无所不知。
So the Bhattacharya said, "You please sit here and take your food."
巴达扎亚说，请您坐在这里开始进餐吧。
But Lord Chaitanya said, no, this place, this has been used by Krishna. This is Krishna's place.
但是主柴丹尼亚说，这个地方是值得崇拜的，因为它是 Krishna 用过的。
It's the etiquette that whatever is used by Krishna is not used by anybody else.
按照礼节 ，Krishna 用过的事物，别的人就不能再用。
And even the things used by the spiritual master are not supposed to be used by anyone else.
甚至灵性导师使用过的物品，任何其他的人也不应该再使用。
So especially things like the sitting or the eating place shouldn't be used by anyone else.
尤其是他们的座位或者是他们进餐的地方就不能再由任何其他的人所使用。
Just like the dishes which they use to eat food, the guru, spiritual master or Krishna, they each have their own plates and dishes for taking their prasadam.
例如灵性导师和 Krishna 都有各自的吃饭的餐具。
So the Bhattacharya told Lord Chaitanya, they said both the food and the sitting places are Krishna's mercy.
Bhattacharya 告诉主柴丹尼亚，这些食物和座位都是主的仁慈。
If you can eat the remnants of the food, then there's no offense in you sitting in this place.
如果您可以吃这些食物的剩余的话，那么您坐在这个地方就没有什么冒犯可言了。
So Lord Chaitanya said, yes, you're right. Shastras say that devotee can eat whatever is left by Krishna.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 回答说，是的，你说的正确。经典训谕，奉献者可以去吃 Krishna 吃剩下的食物。
Just like the flower garlands and the clothes worn by Krishna and the ornaments, these things, they, after they've been offered to the deity, they can be used by the devotees.
正如那些花环或者是衣物。事物当被供奉给 Krishna 之后，奉献者们就可以加以使用。
And by eating the remnants of Krishna, you'll be able to conquer over Maya.
通过进食觊觎。就能够征服玛雅虚幻的能量。
So, Uddhava had spoke like that to Lord Krishna.
这番话是 Uddhava 对 Krishna 这样说的。
At that time, there was some trouble in Dwarka. Lord Krishna was decided to leave the material world and go to the spiritual world.
那时候在多尔卡有一些骚乱，主 Krishna 便决定离开的物质世界，返回灵性世界。
Uddhava could understand the thinking, so Uddhava spoke with Krishna.
Uddhava 可以理解他的想法，所以他对 Krishna 便说话。
So when Krishna'spresent in the material world, then it's called Prakat Lila. And when he's not present, it's called Aprakat Lila.
当 Krishna 降临在物质世界的时候，他被称为是 Prakat Lila, 展示了的逍遥时光。当 Krishna 不在这个世界上的时候，他的逍遥时光被称为 Aprakat Lila, 未展示的逍遥时光。
So Krishna's pastimes are going on, just like the sun is always shining. So Krishna's pastimes are always going on.
正如太阳， 永远的在那里照耀。Krishna 的逍遥时光 也永恒存在。
Just like the sun, we have the daylight and we have the night light. When the sun goes out of sight, then there's no sun, but the sun is still there. But we can't feel the sunlight because it's nighttime.
所以当太阳有的时候就在那里，它太阳在的时候就是白天，当太阳不在的时候就是夜晚。
So the Krishna's pastimes are always going on. Sometimes we can see them, sometimes we can't.
Krishna 逍遥时光是永恒长存的，只是有时候我们可以看到，有的时候看不到。
But the pure devotees, with the eye of devotion, they can see all of these things.
但是长着奉爱的眼睛的纯粹奉献者却可以看到。
So Lord Chaitanya said, there's so much food here, it's impossible to eat it all.
主 Chaitanya 说，有这么多的食物，我不可能吃掉所有的食物。
But the Bhattacharya said, well, look, I know how much you can eat.At Jagannath Puri, you eat 52 times a day.
在 Jagannath Puri, 你每天进食52次。
And each time, you eat hundreds of buckets of food.
每一次您都能够吃掉几百桶的食物。
And in Dwarka, you keep 16,000 queens in 16,000 palaces.
在 Dwarka, 您在16,000座皇宫当中供养着16,000位皇后。
And the 18 mothers and so many friends and relatives, all of the Yadu dynasty.
在整个的亚杜王朝有18位母亲，您还有无数的亲朋好友。
And in Vrindavan, you have your father's elder brothers.
在 Vrindavan, 您的父亲还有他，您的父亲有自己的哥哥。
And your father has younger brothers also.
您的父亲也有弟弟。
And then you have all your uncles from your mother's side.
您还有许多位舅舅。
And then your father's sisters all have their husbands.
您的父亲的姐妹也都有各自的丈夫。
And there's so many other cowherd men.
还有那么多的牧牛郎。
And there's all the cowherd boys also.
还有许多的牧牛童。
And you eat twice a day, morning and evening, in the house of each and every person.
您每天早晚在他们每一个人的家中进餐。
The sannyasi is supposed to collect a little bit of food from each house. He won't take a lot of food. He will just each house give a little food, a little piece.
Sannyasi 应该是在每一个房子家中呢，只吃一点点食物。
This is called madukari.It means just like the bird, you collect a little food from each place.
这被称为 madukari, 就像小鸟从每一个地方收集一点点食物。
Actually, it's like the bees. The bees come, they take a little pollen from the flower, then they go to another flower.
就像蜂蜜 从每一朵鲜花当中采集一点点 花粉，然后就去下一朵。
And this way the honey, you get more and more honey, and it becomes, makes a beehive.
就这样，他们酿造了蜂蜜，逐渐这些就积累起一个蜂巢。
So sannyasis, they should take a little food from each house, and they should eat simply, just enough to maintain the body.
就这样 ，sannyasi 应该从每一个居士家中吃很简单的食物，足够维持他们的身体就好了。
So Lord Chaitanya would take a little food from the house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
如柴丹亚本想从 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 家中进食一点点食物。
So compared to the food eaten by Lord Chaitanya on other occasions, the Bhattacharya said, "My feast is nothing. This is hardly a morsel for you."
比起如柴丹尼亚在其他的场合所吃的食物，巴塔恰尔说：“我给你的这些只不过就是一口而已。”
Lord Chaitanya was saying it's too much, but Bhattacharya was saying, "Well, look, you eat so much every day."
如柴丹尼亚说：“这些食物太多了。”但是巴塔恰尔说：“但是这些食物对您来说只是一口而已。”
Every day you're eating in Jagannath Puri 52 offerings, and you're eating in Dwarka in 16,000 palaces, and you're eating in every home of the Brijbasis.
每一天您在 Jagannath Puri 的庙里头都进食52次，在 Dwarka 您在16,000个皇宫当中吃进餐，您还在每一个 Brajabasi 的家中进餐。
So I'm just giving you a little bit of food. Why are you complaining?
我只是给你一点点食物而已，您为什么还要说这太多了呢？
So Lord Chaitanya smiled and he sat down to begin to eat.
就 Chaitanya 就微笑了，他便坐起来开始进餐。
So the Bhattacharya first of all gave him the prasadam from Lord Jagannath.
Bhattacharya 首先给主差殿下端上 Jagannath 庙的 prasadam.
So the Bhattacharya had one, he had a daughter, and the daughter, his daughter was married to a man called Amoga.
Bhattacharya 有一位女儿，他的女儿嫁给了一位名叫 Amoga 的男子。
And this Amoga was from an aristocratic Brahmana family, and he was a fault finder, and he was a blasphemer.
Amoga 出生于一位贵族的婆罗门家庭，他是一个挑错的人，非常善于挑错的人。而且他也是个冒犯亵渎者。
So Amoga wanted to see Lord Chaitanya eat, but he was not allowed to enter.
Amoga 就想监督主柴丹尼吃饭的情况，但是他没有被允许来进入房间。
The Bhattacharya was guarding the door. He had a stick in his hand, guarding the door, not to let him in.
巴达查亚手里拿着一根棍子，就把守着这个入口处，就不允许他进入。
But the Bhattacharya, he began to distribute prasadam, and at that time Amoga took the opportunity to rush in and to see Lord Chaitanya.
当巴达查亚开始派发 prasadam 的时候 ，Amoga 就趁机冲进了房间。就开始说话。
And when he saw all the food, then he began to blaspheme. Oh, look at this!
当他看到了所有的食物之后呢，他一下就开始说话了。哦，看看这么多的食物吧。
This much food is enough here for 10 or 12 men, and this one sannyasi is eating it all by himself.
这些食物足够十个或二十个人吃掉了，但是这一位 Sanyasi 他独自一个人就吃了所有这些食物。
So as soon as Amoga said this, the Bhattacharya heard him and he turned his eyes, and then immediately Amoga ran and he ran away.
当 Amoga 一说出这个话的时候，
The Bhattacharya ran after him with a stick. He was going to beat him with a stick. But Amoga ran because Bhattacharya was a bit older than him, so he couldn't catch him.
Bhattacharya 手里拿着棍子就在后面紧追不舍，但是 Amoga 他跑得特别快，而 Bhattacharya 上了年纪了，所以追不上他。
So the Bhattacharya began to curse his son-in-law and called him ill names.
Bhattacharya 便开始诅咒他的女婿，并且骂了他的坏话。
And when he came back to his house, he saw Lord Chaitanya was laughing, because Lord Chaitanya was laughing to hear Bhattacharya criticize his son-in-law.
卢柴丹尼亚听到巴达查亚批评他的女婿的时候就笑了起来。
And when the Bhattacharya's wife heard what had happened, then she began to hit her own head and her chest, and she was saying again and again, she said, let my daughter become a widow.
当巴达查亚的妻子听到了这个事件之后，他开始捶胸顿足，并且反反复复地说，让我的女儿成寡妇吧。
So when Lord Chaitanya saw how both the Bhattacharya and his wife were so sorry, they were in such a painful condition, he tried to pacify them.
当主柴丹尼亚看到巴达查亚和他的妻子这么难过悲伤的时候，就开始安慰他俩。
So he, according to their desire, he ate quite a bit of prasadam. He was very satisfied.
为了满足了他们两个人的愿望，他就吃了很多的 prasadam， 变得心满意足了。
And Lord Chaitanya finished eating. The Bhattacharya poured water for the Lord to wash his mouth and hands and legs.
当主柴丹尼亚吃完之后，巴达查亚就给主倒了一点水，让他漱口、洗手、洗腿。
And then gave him some nice spices to put in his mouth to make a nice taste.
并且给他呈现了一点点香料，让他放在口中。
And then he gave Lord Chaitanya a nice flower garland and put sandalwood on him.
给主柴丹尼亚献上一串花环，并且给他涂上了檀香浆。
And then the Bhattacharya began to speak to Lord Chaitanya, and he said, "I brought you to my home just to have you blasphemed."
然后巴达查亚对主柴丹尼亚说：“我把你带到我家，只是为了让……结果呢？就是您，结果您却受到了亵渎。”
So this is a great offense. Please forgive me. I beg your pardon.
这是巨大的冒犯，请宽恕原谅我。我恳求您的宽恕。
But Lord Chaitanya said, "No, what Amoga said was true. It is not blasphemy."
但是主柴丹尼亚说，不，Amoga说的是真话。并没有亵渎。
What offense have you done?
您做了什么冒犯呢？
So Lord Chaitanya then left and went back to his home, and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya took him to his home.
说完，主柴丹尼亚就离开了，返回到自己的住所。Sarvabhauma 就带着他回到他的住所。
And Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was still feeling very pained very sorry about what had happened, and he was falling at Lord Chaitanya's feet and he was begging forgiveness. So then the Bhattacharya came back home and he talked to his wife. And he was together, they considered what to do. So the Bhattacharya said to his wife, he said, if a man blasphemes Lord Chaitanya, if that man is killed, then his sinful actions are removed.
巴特查尔说，倘若一个人冒犯亵渎了如柴丹娘，当这个人被杀死的时候，他的罪恶反应就得到了，救赎。Yeah,
it's described in another incident. It was a conversation between two great saintly persons. So Markandeya Rishi was describing to Maharaj Bhagirat.
就在另外一个对话，是有两位伟大的Rishi，是Markandeya和Bhagirata之间的对话。So
he said, Markandeya tells Bhagirata, he said, if anybody offends a great devotee, then they lose the results of all their pious activities.
Markandeya就对Bhagirata说。
They will lose all their opulence. They will lose their reputation. And all their sons will die. So Vaishnavas are great souls, and if anybody criticizes them, then they fall to hell. If anybody kills or blasphemes a Vaishnava, whoever he is, if he's envious of a Vaishnava, then he will go to a hellish life.
倘若有人杀害一个Vaishnava，或者是批评一个Vaishnava，那么他会下地狱。And
sinful people who blaspheme devotees are punished very severely by Yamaraj.
亵渎Vaishnava的罪恶之人
If somebody criticizes Lord Vishnu and his devotees, they will lose all of their benefits of all their pious activities. And they'll be put in Kumbhipaka hell, to be bitten by worms. And they'll be bit in that condition as long as the sun and the moon exist. So we should not even look on the face of somebody who criticizes Lord Vishnu and his devotees. And if somebody criticizes the devotees and the Lord, we should immediately leave that place.
We
We should block our ears and go away. If we're unable to punish him, we should block our ears and just go away.
如果我们不能惩罚这个亵渎者，我们应该堵住耳朵，立刻离开。
But if you're able to, you can cut out their tongue and kill the offender.
但是如果可能的话，你应该把他的舌头割下来，杀死这个人。
And after that, you should give up your own life.
在此之后，就应该放弃自己的生命。
So Bhattacharya said, if I give up my own life, then the sinful action will be accounted for.
Bhattacharya 说，倘若我放弃自己的生命，那么这个罪恶反应的结果将会被抵消。
But the Bhattacharya said, I don't think this is a very good idea because I'm a Brahmana and also our son-in-law is also a Brahmana. If I kill him, he's a Brahmana, and if I kill myself, I'm a Brahmana. It's not good.
但是 Bhattacharya 说，我不认为这是一个好主意，因为我是一位婆罗门，我们的女婿也是婆罗门，所以，我杀死婆罗门并不好。
So I never want to see the face of that Amoga again. I reject him.
我再也不想见那位冒犯者 Amoga 的脸了。我现在抛弃了他。
I will never even speak his name again.
我甚至连他的名字也再也不会说出他的名字。
And we should tell our daughter, we should, Sati, we should tell her that she should also leave her husband because her husband has fallen down. When the husband falls down, it's the duty of the wife to finish the relationship. So, this is the thinking of Bhattacharya. He said, it wouldn't be very good for me to commit suicide, and it wouldn't be good for me to kill my son-in-law because we're both Brahmanas.
我自杀也不好，我们杀死我们的女婿也不好。因为我们二人都是婆罗门。
But I'll give up the relationship. That's as good as killing him.
但是我会放弃我们之间的，切断我们的关系，这就如同杀死他一样。
Sometimes they cut the hair from the head and take away all the wealth, and take away the house. That's a punishment for somebody. If somebody is like a Kshatriya, if you cut the hair from their head and take away all their wealth, then that's a punishment.
如果对方是一个Kshatriya的话，有时候他们会把他的头发剃掉，或者把他的所有的财富拿走，或者把他的房子拿走，这是对一位Kshatriya的惩罚。
But Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya just said, tell our daughter, give up the relationship with the husband. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it said, you cannot be a husband if you cannot liberate the dependents from birth and death.
Bhattacharya 说，就告诉我们的女儿，放弃和她丈夫的关系。在圣典波迦瓦坛里说，倘若一个人不能把别人从生死当中拯救出来，那么他就不应该做丈夫。
If a person is not in Krishna consciousness, and if he doesn't have any spiritual power, then he cannot protect his wife from the path of birth and death.
谁要是不在 Krishna 世界当中，并且没有灵性力量的话，他就不能把妻子保护他的妻子免于生死。
So that person cannot make a good husband.
这样的人是不能够成为一位优秀的丈夫的。
So the wife should just dedicate everything to Krishna.
这样妻子应当把一切都供奉给 Krishna。
If the husband gives up Krishna consciousness and she gives up her connection with him, then she follows in the footsteps of the wives of the brahmanas。
倘若丈夫放弃了 Krishna 知觉，妻子就应该放弃跟这样丈夫的联系，她应当追随那些婆罗门妻子的步伐。
There's no wrong in the wife giving up the husband if the husband is fallen。
倘若丈夫是堕落的话，妻子放弃这样的丈夫是没有错误的。
Of course, Krishna told these wives, Krishna told the wives of the brahmanas that your husbands will not neglect you when you go back. You can go back to them, your husbands will accept you. Don't worry.
当然 ,Krishna 就向这些婆罗门的妻子保证说，你们可以放心，你们的丈夫不会忽视你们。当你们返回家中的时候，他们不会忽视，不理睬你们。
You are my pure devotees, Krishna told the wives of the brahmanas. You are my pure devotees. Not only your relatives, but also ordinary people, as well as the demigods, will be pleased with you.
Krishna 对这些婆罗门的妻子们说，你们都是我纯洁的奉献者，不仅仅是你们的亲属，普通大众还有半神都将对你们感到满意。
So love of Krishna doesn't depend on the bodily connection.
对 Krishna 的奉爱是不依赖于躯体的关系而存在的。
But if our mind is always thinking about Krishna, then very soon we will be able to come to be with Krishna.
我们的心意若是恒常专注于 Krishna 的话，很快就能够去就到达 Krishna 那里。
So when a wife is satisfied and is not greedy and is expert and knows religious principles and speaks what is dear and truthful, then.She will be very much devoted to her husband if he is not fallen. Oh, this is a verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam describing about a wife, how her good qualities will be manifest if the husband is not fallen.
A 心满意足不贪婪能干了解宗教原则说话亲切真实的人，她倘若她的丈夫不是堕落的话，她会非常奉献于自己的丈夫。这个诗节出自于圣典博迦瓦塔，描述的是倘若一个人她的丈夫不是堕落的话，那么这样的妻子将会对自己丈夫非常有注意。
So the son-in-law of Amoga, a son-in-law of Bhattacharya, whose name was Amoga, he had to run away. And in the morning, the next morning, he fell sick with cholera.
Sarvam Bhattacharya 的女婿不得不仓皇的就逃走了。第二天清晨，他就得了霍乱。
So when the Bhattacharya heard that Amoga was dying with cholera, he said, "Oh, this is the favor of providence. He is doing what I want to do."
当 Bhattacharya 听说 Amoga 因为霍乱得了霍乱，正要死掉的时候，他说道。这是命运的钟情。由于命使然。
When somebody offends Krishna, then karma immediately takes effect.
谁要是冒犯了 Krishna 的话，那么业报法则就立刻生效了。
So the Bhattacharya then began to quote scriptures to support this.
Bhattacharya 又引述了经典来支持他这个话。
And there's a verse that said, we had to arrange, we took a lot of trouble to collect elephants and horses and chariots. But all of these things have been given by the Gandharvas.
有一个师姐是这样说的，我们要费尽周折来去找来那大象、马匹、战车、步兵，所有这些都由Gandharva已经实现了。
Yeah, the Pandavas were living in exile in the forest.
当时潘度兄弟他们在森林当中流放。
So there was a fight between the Kauravas and the Gandharvas.
在 Kaurava 和 Gandharva 之间展开了一场战斗。
So the Kauravas, their leader was Karna.
Kaurava 军队的首领是 Karna.
But the Gandharvas, they arrested all of the Kauravas. They were stronger than them and they defeated them.
Gandharva, 因为他们的军事力量更加强大，所以打败了 Kaurava, 就把他们抓了起来。
So Duryodhana's ministers, they came to Maharaj Yudhisthira and they begged him, please help us.
Duryodhana 的大臣们就来找 Maharaj Yudhisthira, 对他说，请帮助我们。
So the Pandavas went and they helped and they freed the Kauravas from the Gandharvas.
Pandu 五兄弟就去把 Kaurava 们营救了出来。
So Grandfather Bhishma, he thought it was right. It was good that Duryodhana and all of his brothers, they all got arrested.
Bhishma,
yeah.
那 Bhishma 就想起了 Duryodhana 所有的以前的暴行。
They did it. The Pandavas didn't have to do it. The Pandavas, it would have been a lot of trouble for the Pandavas to arrest Duryodhana and all the people. But the Gandharvas came, they did it very easily.
如果要是 Pandava,五兄弟让他们去找召集来所有那些大象、马匹、步兵的话，那么是很困难的。但这件事情却由Gandharva呢，他们轻而易举的实现了。
And then the other verse which he quotes is about Lord Krishna's about Kamsa attempting to kill Lord Krishna's sister, Yogamaya.
还有另外一个师节是有关于 Kamsa 试图杀死 Krishna 的妹妹 Yogamaya 的事情。
Right? Kamsa was afraid that the eighth child born to Devaki was going to kill him.
Kamsa 担心 Devaki 的第八个儿子将会杀了他。
So when he heard that Devaki had delivered the child, Kamsa came there to the prison house and he took the child away from Devaki and he tried to kill her. So...Of course, Vasudev had exchanged the child, his child had been born, Vasudev Krishna. Vasudev went to Gokul and he gave He gave the child who was born to Dak Vasudevan Devaki, and he took the girl who was born to Yashoda. So he brought the girl, Yogamaya, back to the prison house in Mathura. So when Kamsa heard the child had been born, Kamsa came there to the prison and he wanted to kill that child. And he grabbed the baby from Devaki and he tried to kill it, but the child rose up in the air. And at that time she told Kamsa that the child who is going to kill you is already born some other place.
他就告诉康萨，要杀死你的那个新生儿已经在别的地方诞生了。
So, this there's a verse that says, when a person mistreats great souls, then his lifespan is reduced.
有一个诗节说，倘若一个人他
And all of his opulences, they're all destroyed. So, people who are demons, they can lose everything because of their demonic activities.
恶魔们因为他们的恶魔行径，他们就会丧失一切。
And the problem of their sin is they're envious of Lord Vishnu and they're envious of the devotees.
他们的罪孽就是在于他们嫉妒主的奉献者。
The devotees are always busy in the service of Krishna. And the demons don't like that. Because they are envious of Krishna and his devotees, so nothing is ever auspicious for the demons. They lose everything. So a devotee, another devotee, he went to tell Lord Chaitanya about the situation. He said, you know, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and his wife are both fasting. And Amoga, their son-in-law, he is dying of cholera. So one devotee came and told Lord Chaitanya this news.
有一位奉献者就去找主柴丹雅，就告诉他一个消息，对他说：“Sarvabhauma和他的妻子两个人都在绝食，而他们的女婿Amoga因为得了霍乱，正在死掉。”So
Lord Chaitanya immediately went running to the where they were, and he found Amoga, and Lord Chaitanya put his hand on his chest, and he told him, he said, the heart of a Brahmin is very clean. It should be very clean. It's a place where Krishna sits.
他把他的手放在Amoga的胸膛上，对他说道：“一位婆罗门的内心本性是非常纯净的，他是主Krishna居坐的恰当的地方。”
So don't allow jealousy to stay in your heart.
不要允许嫉妒留在你的心中。
Your heart should be the most pure place, but you've contaminated it with this jealousy.
你的心本来应当是一个最纯净的地方，但是你却用嫉妒污染了它。
But because you've got the association of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, all of your contamination is now finished.
但是由于你跟 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 的联谊，你的所有的污染现在都摧毁了。
And when your heart is clean, then you're able to chant the Maha Mantra.
一旦你的内心干净之后，你就能够唱诵 Maha Mantra。
So now get up and chant Hare Krishna Mantra.
现在请站起来，唱诵 Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
And Krishna will give his mercy to you.
Krishna 将给予你仁慈。
So a Brahmana can chant the Hare Krishna Mantra, but he may not be chanting purely. He may chant with offense.
因为婆罗门可能唱诵 Hare Krishna， 但是他可能不是纯粹的唱诵，可能是带着冒犯唱诵。
But when he starts to understand his, when he starts to do service for Krishna, then he begins to purify himself.
一旦他开始为 Krishna 从事服务的话，他就能够净化自身。
Then he becomes a devotee and he gets free of contamination.
之后他成为奉献者，就能摆脱一切污染。
A Brahmana may be a scholar, but does not mean that he's without, he may be a scholar, but he may also be very contaminated materially.
因为婆罗门也许是一位身为学者，但是仍然可能会受到物质的污染。
The Brahmana's contamination is in the mode of goodness.
因为婆罗门的污染是处在善良形态的。
So devotee is transcendental.
而奉献者是超然的。
If you become a devotee,by proper initiation, then you automatically become a Brahmana.
倘若通过恰当的洗涤成为奉献者的话，那么自动就成为了婆罗门。
So, we want to become devotees.
因此，我们希望做奉献者。
Okay, so then what happened after? Lord Chaitanya touched him and Amoga immediately stood up and began to chant the Hare Krishna mantra. He began to chant and dance in ecstasy.
他开始以唱歌跳舞，在狂喜当中又载歌载舞。
And he showed all kinds of symptoms of ecstatic love. Lord Chaitanya was laughing at him.
他展示出所有狂喜的征候，主柴他那就开始笑。
Then he fell, and Amoga fell at the feet of Lord Chaitanya and begged him. He said, "Please forgive me for all my offenses."
阿摩格就拜倒在主的莲花足下，恳求主说：“请您原谅我的冒犯。”
And he began to slap his own face. He was slapping his cheeks again and again. He said, "By my use my mouth to blaspheme you." And he was slapping his face. It all became red and swollen.
阿摩格就开始抽自己的耳光，一遍又一遍地抽着，说道。我用这张嘴，我亵渎了您。他一遍又一遍地扇自己的耳光，直到他的脸颊都变得又红又肿。
And they had to grab his hand and stop him and say, "God, stop it, you'll injure yourself."
旁边的人不得不抓住他的手，对他说，不要这样做，你已经把自己打伤了。
You are the son-in-law of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, and you're worthy of my affection, Lord Chaitanya said.
如 Chaitanya 说，你是Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 的儿子，你是我的慈爱的对象。
He said, everybody in the house of Sarvabhauma's, everyone in his house, the servants and the maids, even his dog, they're all dear to me.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 家中的一切，他的女仆，他的仆人，甚至连他的狗，都是对我非常亲切的。
So now you must chant the Hare Krishna mantra and don't commit any, don't do any more offenses.
现在你必须要唱诵 Hare Krishna Mahamantra, 不要做任何进一步的冒犯。
Then Lord Chaitanya went to see the Bhattacharya, and he took hold of the feet of the Bhattacharya, and Lord Chaitanya embraced both of them, and he got them to sit down, and he talked to them.
之后呢，才跟着妈巴布就去了 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 的家。Sarvabhauma 就抓住了主的莲花足，主拥抱了他们两个人，让他们坐了下来。
He said, "Amoga is just a child. What is the fault? You are fasting. Why are you angry?"
主才跟人家说 ，Amoga 他只是个孩子而已。他有什么错呢？你为什么要戒食呢？为什么你要生气
？So now, take your bath and go to see Lord Jagannath. Then come back here and take your lunch. Then I will be happy.
如柴太娘说：“现在你去沐浴，然后觐见主扎格纳达的脸，之后你返回到这里吃午餐。”这样我将会感到很满意。
I'm going to stay here until you come back to take your lunch.
我会一直留在这里，直到你返回来吃你的午餐。
And the Bhattacharya says to Lord Chaitanya, "Why did you save his life? Why did you bring him back? Better he died."
Bhattacharya 就对住柴田家说。为什么你要让阿猫哥起死复生？他还不如去死掉好了。
Lord Chaitanya said, "No, no. He's just a child. He is your son. Father should not take the faults of the son so seriously."
主柴太娘说：“不不不，阿猫哥就只是个孩子而已，他是你的儿子。父亲不应当对儿子的错误看得太重。”
And now he's become a devotee, so you have to give mercy to him.
现在他已经变成了奉献者，所以你必须要给予他仁慈。
So in this way, Lord Chaitanya pacified the mind of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
就这样，如 Chaitanya 就安抚了 Bhattacharya 的心意。
So Lord Chaitanya went to see Lord Jagannath. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya took his bath and then went to see Jagannath and then came home to take his lunch.
之后是 Chaitanya 就去觐见主 Jagannath. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 沐浴之后也去去见主 Jagannath. 之后他返回家中吃了食物。
And Amoga became a great devotee of Lord Chaitanya. And he danced in ecstasy and he chanted the holy name of Lord Krishna.
Amoga 就成为了主 Chaitanya 的纯粹奉献者，他在狂喜当中跳舞，他唱诵主 Krishna 的圣名。
So we see within this one pastime of Lord Chaitanya taking lunch, that Bhattacharya, we see many pastimes.
所以从这一段，主 Chaitanya 吃午餐的逍遥时光当中，我们看到里面有很多的教导。
Okay, so we're finished here. So we'll ask.
那我们
的。Is there any questions?
Yes. 第一个问题。Raja Rani, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj. 那些那些 Chaitanya。去见主 Chaitanya 的 Grihastha， 他们的妻子也跟着丈夫见主 Chaitanya 了吗？他们的妻子不是，他们是一起去了三四个月，还是留在家里了呢？ Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj， those Grihastha when they go to see Lord Chaitanya， their wives also go with their husband， or they remain at home?
Well, it would depend. Sometimes they may go with their husbands. Just like when they would come from Bengal to go to Jagannath Puri, sometimes they'd bring their wives and children with them. Lord Chaitanya knew the children. Sometimes he would give the names of the children. But you have to understand, the Vedic culture is very strict. Lord Chaitanya was a sannyasi. No woman could come near him. So usually the women, they wouldn't come, or they'd be in another room or another part of the building or something. They wouldn't be anywhere near Lord Chaitanya.
Veda 文化是非常严格的。如 Chaitanya 身为一位 sannyasi, 他不允许任何女色接近他。女性会待在另一个房间里，或待在另外一座楼房里。
And he couldn't even say the name of a woman in front of Lord Chaitanya. So, usually the women, you know, they would be other, like Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's wife, she would be in the kitchen cooking. She won't serve. She won't serve the food. The food would be served by the husband.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 的妻子，她就待在厨房里，所以她不会出来给主 Chaitanya 派食物，食物是由她的丈夫来派发的。
Yeah, women are not supposed to serve sannyasis.
Sannyasi 不应该由女性来服侍 sannyasi 进餐。
Yeah.
下一个。Bhakti D, 感谢 Guru. 自杀身亡，下世成鬼魂，请问奉献者自杀会怎样？ Thank you. One who commits suicide in their next life, they will become ghosts. What about devotee who commits suicide?
Well, I don't know. We have to ask Krishna, see what Krishna thinks.
不知道，这得问 Krishna， 但 Krishna 是怎么想？
You have to consider the circumstances. What happened?
需要考虑在当时的情况是怎么样的，到底发生了什么事情？
In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it describes that Sanatana Goswami wanted to commit suicide. He wanted to throw himself under the wheel of Lord Jagannath.
In Chaitanya Charitamrita, this book, Sanatana Goswami wanted to commit suicide. He 他将把头身于主扎达那的盘车紧盘车的轮子车轮下面。
But Lord Chaitanya said, you cannot go back to Godhead just by committing suicide.
主柴丹尼亚对他说，你不能通过自杀回归神手。
Another time, Raghunath was going to jump off Govardhan Hill to commit suicide.
还有一次 ，Raghunath Das 想要纵身跳下高尔丹山自杀。
But Rupa and Sanatan told him, "You can't do this. This will not please Lord Chaitanya."
Rupa 和 Sanatan 阻止了他，说。你不能这么做，这一种做法不能取悦主释迦牟尼。
And Murari Gupta, he had a knife. He was going to commit suicide. He wanted to kill himself. So Lord Chaitanya came there and told him, he said, "Give me that knife." He said, "You cannot kill yourself."
Murari Gupta 就在房子里藏了一把刀，想要自尽。但是主柴丹尼亚就来到他的房子里头，对他说：“你交出这把刀，你不能这么做。”
So we don't encourage people to commit suicide.
所以我们不鼓励人们去自杀。
The body doesn't belong to us; it's given to us by the grace of Krishna.
这具躯体不属于我们。是由于主 Krishna 的仁慈，这具躯体才被给予我们。
We're meant to use it for the service of Krishna.
我们应当利用这个躯体来服务主。
Okay.
下一个，心满，顶拜布玛染。如何理解婆罗门的污染是善良属性的？How can we understand that the contamination of Brahmana is in the mode of goodness?
How to understand the Brahmana is in the mode of goodness?
The contamination of the Brahmana is in the mode of goodness because Lord Chaitanya called the Amoga in the lecture.
Oh, yeah.There was contamination. He said, give up that contamination from the heart. Okay, so, yes, he was a Brahmana externally, but that jealousy was not the pro- that's not really the quality, that's not a quality of a Brahmana. And that quality was degrading him. And Lord Chaitanya told him, you have to get rid of that quality.
但是他内心有着嫉妒的品性，所以这种品性并不是婆罗门的品性，这嫉妒品性就使得他堕落。主柴丹尼亚就让他放弃这个品性。
Brahmanas are not meant to be envious of anyone. That's not a Brahminical quality.
婆罗门不应当嫉妒任何生物，这并非婆罗门的品性。
So Lord Chaitanya told Amoga, you give up this envy. Get that envy out of your heart.
Lord Chaitanya told Amoga, 你放弃这个嫉妒品性，把它从你内心踢出去。
And when you get rid of the envy, then you'll become a proper Brahmana.
当你去除了嫉妒的品性，就能成为一位真正的婆罗门。
But he was a Brahmana in name only, but he didn't have the qualities because he was envious and fault finder of Lord, he criticized Lord Chaitanya. If one may be a Brahmana in name, but you may not have the qualities of a Brahmana, you're not really a Brahmana.
一个人也许他名义上是婆罗门，但是他要是不具备婆罗门的品质，就不是一个真正的婆罗门。
Okay.
下一个是 Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and all devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. How do we develop humility towards the material world? We should consider ourselves servants of Krishna and the Vaishnavas, but we are not servants of the materialists, are we? 另一个问题是 Hare Krishna, 顶拜Guru, 所有荣耀归于Prabhupada, 我们怎样发展 对物质世界的谦卑心态, 我们应当自认为是 Krishna 和 Vaishnava 的仆人, 但是不是物质主义者的仆人, 对吧? 对吗?
Well, we develop humility by chanting the holy name and by offering all respects to others.
我们通过唱诵主的圣名, 尊敬别人,
and not being anxious to be respected ourselves also.
不期望得到就是自己得到别人的尊敬。
So the Shikshastikam, the third verse, is very helpful for us to become humble. Follow the instructions of the third verse of Shikshastikam.
主的八训规的第三条, 特别有助于我们发展培养谦卑的品性, 所以如果想培养这个品性, 就要遵守这个第三条的教。And
a devotee, you say, is a devotee, is not meant to be the servant of everyone, is only meant to, well, actually we are the servant of everyone, because even though they're not devotees, they're materialistic people, we should try to give them Krishna consciousness and we should serve them in that way.
我们是通过努力给予他们 Krishna 之觉，以这种方式来服务他们。
Yeah, we should be compassionate on all the fallen souls.
我们应当对所有堕落灵魂心存怜悯。
So showing compassion for them, that is service to Krishna.
向他们展示怜悯，这个就是对 Krishna 的服务。
We can show compassion for them by chanting Hare Krishna, taking part in Sankirtan, distributing books, and distributing prasadam. We do these things for the benefit of the conditioned souls.
我们做这些事情就能给受条件限制的灵魂带来好处。
So we are definitely their servants.
所以无疑我们确实是他们的仆人。
Because we see Krishna's in their heart.
因为我们在他们内心看见Krishna。
And we think how to bring them to Krishna consciousness.
我们想着如何把他们带到 Krishna 知觉中。
And we want to help them to come to Krishna consciousness.
我们希望帮助他们进入到 Krishna 知觉中。 下一个问题。 Panchatattva 二部，顶拜Maharaj，主持人和所有Vaishnava奉献者， Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 非常严厉诅咒 Amogha。 这是冒犯吗？Amogha后来成为奉献者，这冒犯如何消除呢？ Obeisance Maharaj, a Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya cursed Amogha very severely. Is it an offense? Because Amogha later on became devotee. So how to counteract this offense?
No, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya didn't commit offense. He just said that because Amogha had committed an offense, Amogha had blasphemed Lord Chaitanya, so Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said that his daughter should give up her relationship with that man who was supposed to be her husband.
这不是一个冒犯, 因为 Amoga 冒犯亵渎了 Chaitanya， 所以 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就说他们的女儿应当放弃与这个男子的关系，这个这男应该放弃跟这个不应当是她丈夫的这个男子跟她切断关系。
So Sarvabhauma, but once Amoga had been made into a devotee by Lord Chaitanya, then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya then forgave him.
一旦 Amoga 成为了奉献者之后， Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就原谅了他。
So his daughter would stay with Amoga. She didn't have to leave her husband.
那么她的女儿就可以跟 Amoga 待在一起，就不需要离开她了。
You know, initially, he was saying, "My daughter's a widow. Take it. Don't go with him. Don't go near that man again. He's fallen. He's a sinful person. So stay away from him."
一开始，就是他说我的女儿，她应当成为寡妇，不要再去接近那个人了。那个人太堕落、罪恶，应该远离他。
So he wasn't cursing Amoga, he was just describing his situation. And he said he didn't want his daughter to stay in that association with that man. But after Lord, by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, the whole situation was resolved, and Amoga became a devotee, chanted Hare Krishna, and became humble.
由于主 Chaitanya 的仁慈，整个的问题都化解了。Amoga 就成为了奉献者，他唱诵了 Hare Krishna， 得到，后来他变得谦卑。
So there was no.Sarvabhauma didn't curse him, so there was no problem.
Sarvabhauma 并没有诅咒他，所以并不存在诅咒的这个事情。下一个 Sumukhi Radha， 明白杜玛拉的奉献者，父母批评孩子，老师批评学生，作为教官和某些岗位的职责就是挑错改错，这会成为一种习惯。这其中是否有嫉妒成分呢？如何尽职尽责，又不伤害对方的自尊心呢？ So Sumukhi Radha said that, Vaisnavara, sometimes the parents have to criticize their children, and the teachers have to criticize the students. Sometimes there are some jobs.There are some position, their duty is to correct, make correction. It will become a habit. Are there any element of envy in this job? How can we do our own job at the same time, not hurt the prestige of others, self-esteem of others.
Well, your judgment, your correction of the people, in correcting them, you have to do it properly, you have to do it according to their qualification. You have to be able to recognize what is the fault with the student or with the child,And you have to point it out to them so that the criticism should be fair and it should be logical and you should be able to present it to the person so that they can understand their fault.
一个人可以确实的、合理的认出对方的错误， 来认出这个孩子或者学生的错误，这个批评呢必须是公平合理的，并且是合情合理的来，并且让对方合情合理的呈现给对方，让对方能够理解他们所犯的错误。
If you're going to be a teacher or you're going to be a parent, then sometimes you do have to find the fault and you have to make it known to the person. You have to make it known to your student or to your child, you know, that this is not right, you can't do like this, you have to stop that. They, first of all, they have to accept your authority.
作为老师和父母，必须要有时候必须要挑错，而且要让对方知道他们的错误，让学生和孩子们承认自己的错误。你父母和老师要对这个学生孩子说，这个这样做是不对的，不能再这么做了。但是这个学生孩子他必须得接受你的权威才行。
So if you're doing the work of a parent and you're trying to give instruction to your child, it's important that you show them the right example, that you cannot do something which is wrong and expect them not to do it.
作为父母，这种训导者的角色很重要的一点就是要以身作则。你父母不能去做，你不希望孩子去做的错事。
Just like if you tell your children don't smoke, but you smoke, then you can't expect the children not to smoke. You're telling them don't smoke, but you smoke. You're not showing the example. So that kind of teaching is useless.
比如说，如果父母不希望孩子抽烟，那么父母自己就不应该抽烟。否则的话，他这样的纠正孩子，那就是没有用处的。
So you're giving instruction to people, they have to be willing to accept you as a qualified teacher and to respect your authority.
倘若要给别人训导的话，别人必须要愿意心甘情愿的接受，那你本身要做一个合格的老师，并且对方愿意接受你的尊敬你，接受你的尊敬你的权威。
So you have to give the instructions with love. They have to feel that you have a genuine loving concern for them. And it's not just a nasty chastisement.
倘若你要是训导别人的话，他们对方要必须的感受到你的爱心。你必须感化他们，用你的爱和关怀感化他们，而不是那个令人讨厌的那种一味的斥责。
So it's a delicate balance, you know, to know the balance between, you know, praising and criticizing. If all the time you criticize, it's not good. So there has to be sometimes criticism and sometimes praise. You have to show a balance. You have to show genuine appreciation for the efforts of the student.
所以，要有那个敏感度，要能把握住这里面的微妙的平衡，不能一味的批评指责，还必须要真心的赞美、欣赏对方。要保持这种赞美和批评，就是纠正的平衡。
So personal relationships are very important. You have to have a genuine, caring, personal, loving exchange with the person who's under your guidance.
个人的就是关系很重要，必须有一种真心的关怀，用个人，就是人与人之间的真心的交流，真心的关心。
Yeah.
下一个是 Inna says thank you very much for your mercy. Stars are spotty, David Dasit. 顶戴孤乳所有奉献者，奉献者的财产被恶魔夺去了，是夺回来还是容忍呢？ Obeisance Guru and all devotees, if the possession of devotees are taken away, snatched away by demons, should devotees take it back or to tolerate it?
Well, if you can get it back, then you should take it back, yes.
如果能夺回来，能夺回来，那就是应该去夺回来。
Because whatever you have, we're using it for the service of Krishna. So if people take it away, it's disturbing our service to Krishna. So you should try to take it back.
我们用的一切都是为来用来服务 Krishna 的。如果被拿走的话，就会打扰我们的服务。那么我们应该把它拿回来。
Okay.
Manini Radha, 顶戴 Maharaj 的奉献者，请问 Maharaj 如何去除内心的骄傲污染，如何不再犯同样的错误 ？Obeisant Maharaj and devotees, Maharaj, how can we get rid of the contamination of the proud pride in our heart, and how can we do not make the same mistake again? How can we make sure that we don't make the same mistake again?
Well, you have to engage fully in devotional service. Simply by engaging in the process of bhakti yoga, you automatically acquire all the good qualities.
必须要全完全的从事奉爱服务，只要就是只是通过 Bhakti Yoga 奉爱瑜伽，一个人就能自动培养起所有美好的优秀品质。
We saw yesterday Lord Chaitanya told the devotee, "It's to constantly chant Hare Krishna and serve the Vaishnavas whenever you get a chance. Do service for the Vaishnavas."
昨天的讲课当中。如柴丹尼亚对信士奉献者，当奉献者返回孟加拉的时候，如柴丹尼亚说：“你们应当恒常的唱诵 Hare Krishna， 并且服务 Vaishnava。一旦有机会，就要抓住机会来服务 Vaishnava。”
So when you serve the Vaishnavas, they will bless you, and that will help us to get purified and to develop good qualities.
所以，倘若我们要是服务了 Vaishnava， 就能得到 Vaishnava 的祝福，这样呢就能获得净化，培养起美好优秀的品质。
But you have to be careful. Don't become proud. When they bless you, when they praise you, don't become proud. You should think I'm very fallen, and just remember that.
但是你要很谨慎，千万不要骄傲。倘若拜师那瓦祝福了你，你也不要因为他们的赞美而沾沾自喜，要认为自己很堕落，要时刻记住这一点。
So we have to constantly engage in chanting and hearing and serving and offering prayers and worshipping. All of these activities will keep us humble and help us to develop the good qualities.
所以我们的恒常的唱诵、聆听、祈祷、崇拜，保持谦卑，所有这些奉爱服务的活动都能够令我们保持谦，培养起优秀的品质。
Yeah.
下一个 ，Bhakti B， 服务 Vaishnava， 有的服务超出自己的能力，做不到怎么办？一不为。Serve Vaishnavas, but some service is out of our capacity. We cannot do it. So, what to do?
Well, you have to tell the Vaishnava and look. You can either explain to them that you're not able to do this, or you can find some other devotee who can do it.
你就诚实的告诉 Vaishnava。解释一下，说你做不到，或者这是一种方法，就是告诉他你做不到。另外一种方法是找一个能够做到的、能够服务 Vaishnava 的人去服务。
And help them to do it, and learn from them how to do it.
帮助他们服务 Vaishnava， 向他们学习如何服务 Vaishnava。 下一个问题， Chandra Vilasini， 请教姑，我现在在网上联谊占多数，那么在网上如何做可以更好的去服务奉献者呢？感谢姑。 Chandra Vilasini said that now we are most of our association is on the internet. Now how can we do better on the internet association to better serve devotees? Thank you.
Well, we can just be thinking how to expand Krishna consciousness, how to reach more people, maybe make some new topics and some new programs and try to attract the attention of other people, new people, bring them to Krishna consciousness.
我们可以通过网络扩展 Krishna 之觉，想着怎么去接触更多的人，拓展新的活动，拓展新的节目，来吸引新人，帮助他们培养 Krishna 之觉。
We always want to be thinking about so many people don't know about Krishna. So try to find some way to find a subject matter which will interest them to bring them to Krishna.
我们应当想着有这么多的人都不知道 Krishna 之觉，所以我们要想方设法的寻找那些主题，这些主题可以把它通过这些主题把他们带到 Krishna 知觉当中。
So we want to use everything in the service of Krishna.
我们想调动一切来服务 Krishna， 应用一切来服务 Krishna。
So keep thinking and think, and Krishna one day will help us, give us some ideas how we can do it.
所以请您继续集思广益想办法，Krishna 会帮助我们来使我们激发我们内心，能够想出一些新点子、新主意。No, no more. They said thank you.
Okay. No more questions. Okay, thank you very much. So, I'm very thankful to all of you. Especially my thanks to Guru Mani Mataji and to Danakili Mataji for their wonderful translation. And thank all the devotees for their questions and for their participation. I'm very glad that I had the opportunity to spend these last 7 days with you discussing topics of Krishna.
马拉说他非常感谢大家，就允许他过去7天的时间，能允许他来在这几天讲述有关 Krishna 的话题，允许可以跟大家一起来度过这几天的时光。
And I look forward to have your association again as soon as possible.
期待着能够在最短的时间呢，能够和大家再次的联谊。
So I keep you all of you in my prayers, and please also pray for me, and pray that we can all be together sometime in the future.
我会在我的祈祷当中为你们所有人祈祷，也请你们所有的人为我祈祷，在你们的祈祷当中也把我放在你们祈祷当中。我希望我们在不远的将来能够再次重逢，再次在一起。
We'll be together either physically or virtually.
或者是我们能够有机会亲身在一起联谊，或者是能够 就是通过这种空中的形式能够在一起。
But you're always in my heart, and I'm always grateful for your kindness to me, and I pray to Krishna for your continued advancement.
你们都在我的，在我的内心，我非常感谢你们，你们的好心好意，所以我向 Krishna 祈祷，为你们的不断的灵性进步向 Krishna 祈祷。
So thank you all again very much. And my thanks also to the Beijing management headed by Sandini Mataji and the other members there for organizing this.
我也感谢北京的 Sandini Mataji, 北京的 Sandini Mataji 和其他的组织者组织了本次活动。
Okay, so...Thank you all again very much. Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Good day.
Yeah.
Radhika Priya Madaji, 她说还有一个问题可以吗？
可以，可以。Radhika Priya.
Yeah. Next question. Radhika Priya said that, the KGB do not allow us to spread Krishna consciousness. And many devotees are invited by them. They invite many devotees to their place. So how, what's your opinion on this issue?This is from Krishna Nandas. It's a policeman, the public security man. They don't allow us to spread, and they call us to their place.
Yes. So, what's the question?
He asked your opinion. He said, we are warned not to spread Krishna consciousness to others anymore. So he asked, what's your opinion on this issue? And the public security men, they warn us not to accommodate.
Well, we have to understand Krishna consciousness is naturally in the heart of every living entity.
We have to understand Krishna consciousness is naturally in the heart of every living entity.在每一个生物的心中，天然的就有 Krishna 直觉。
You may not be spreading it, but you can cultivate it yourself privately.
您可能不去传播，但是您可以私下里在您自己的内心来培养 Krishna 直觉。
We will be happy to do the work to spread it, and you just cultivate it yourself in your heart.
We will be very happy to spread it. You can cultivate it in your heart.
So you're not doing anything wrong.
You haven't done anything wrong.
So, don't worry, just leave it to, you know, let the foreigners do the propaganda work.
所以不要担心，把这个传播的工作就留给外国人来做。
That's my thinking. Okay. So we pray for your safety. Stay safe. Stay happy. Stay healthy. And look forward to being in touch with you again sometime.
我们为您的安全祈祷，所以请您继续保护自己的安全，让自己快乐起来，让自己健康，保持健康。希望期待着能够跟您再次取得联系接触，让跟您保持接触。
There's always obstacles in everything we do. There will be some difficulties. Cannot expect there will be no troubles. There will be difficulties.
无论我们做什么事情，到处都有障碍。我们不能期望着一切都顺利，会有麻烦的，会有困难的。
But if we take shelter of the holy name, fix our mind on the lotus feet of Krishna, then certainly they can overcome all the obstacles.
我们托庇圣灵，我们专注于 Krishna 的莲花足，那么一切的障碍都会得到克服。
Okay. So thank you very much. We will stop here.
非常感谢大家，我们就停到这里。
Okay, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai. 刚才咕噜还说非常感谢，Ganakriya Mataji 还有 Guru Mani Mataji 非常甜美的翻译。
对，我们也感谢所有的奉献者 Jujur。Subhuti Rai Prabhu Jujur, Sati Mataji Jujur.
Recording stopped.
Okay, Hare Krishna.